Hi guys, I'm Alex and this video about new feature of Kinetic Assistant, Aerotow. You know that Flight Simulator does not support soaring yet and does not have winch at all features. So Kinetic Assistant uses SimConnect to cover this problem. You can use any generic or player aircraft as a tag, except legacy aircraft. I will show you three possible ways of towing. First, create a generic plane in front of you, which will take off immediately. We can name it Express Towing. It can be used anywhere, even on the field or runway. Second, tow plane will be created on the parking of airfield and proceed to taxiing. It is ATC related, so if runway or taxi path are busy, it will stay and wait. Most of small airfields can be used for this method, as does not have parking or taxiways. So use it only as a backup method and if you're sure that your airfield supports it. And last, human player will take role of tow plane pilot. It is main method because it provides best experience, but pilot should have some skills and knowledge to tow you properly. Number 1. Express tow plane. It is default method, so you can use it right after program launch. You don't need flight plan or to be on the runway, but in this example I will choose runway anyway. Launch the program, press connect and go to Aerotow tab. Choose preferred elasticity and tow plane model. At this moment, when video was made, not all planes take off properly after insertion, so you can use only those that above this separator. When you're ready, press IE tow button and wait for about 5 seconds. Set required flaps position and ready for launch. Plane will gain cruise airspeed really quickly, and same time it will gain altitude slowly. So be ready to avoid buildings and trees as AI does not care about them. Use spoilers and flaps to control the speed and altitude. Try to follow the same path as tow plane. Another problem, as plane not linked with ATC and has no flight plan, it will always follow north. When you're ready and gain required altitude, disable tow plane scanning by hotkey and rope will be released. Number 2. Park it tow plane. This is alternative method as it has a lot of problems because of current game limitations. But you may have better experience with it. Very important to create flight plan before you start the flight, as tow plane will appear in departure airport. If you will not select both arrival and departure airports, tow plane will not appear. To insert AI tow plane into airfield scene, you have to check Realistic tow plane procedures option in program settings. Select preferred rope and connection point parameters. And this time you can choose any aircraft you want. Press AI tow button and wait until plane taxi to the runway. It does not care about your position, so be ready to release the rope in case of collision danger. If tow plane stuck and turning around, some object block it, like ground service unit or another airplane, or even you. Try to use slew mode to raise yourself several meters up. If it takes longer than 10 seconds, you can try to create another tow plane, sometimes it helps. If tow plane moving away from the runway, it means airfield has no taxiways, and you can't use this method here. After plane stops on the runway, prepare to take off. In this case, plane will follow flight plan, current airport altitude and speed limits. When next waypoint reached, it will speed up and even decrease altitude, so you have to release rope manually at this moment. Number 3. Multiplayer tall plane. This is most exciting way to deliver regulator into soaring site, because it is a teamwork. You have to communicate with pilot to take off successfully. Wait until plane will take the position. Press scan button to see the distance to the plane. Set required elasticity and tip as a pilot. Because SimConnect does not show nearby player's aircraft, you have to search pilot objects near to you. On pilot command, connect the rope. Tell pilot that you are ready to take off. He should start to move slowly to remove slack from the rope. But in this video he did not make it, so movement start was rough and lift off was too early. In the flight, always follow plane movement trajectory. Even if you can't affect dynamics of another player in the game, in real life significant shift can be dangerous. When you're ready, tell pilot that you are going to release rope. On confirm, release tow rope and make right turn.